This video demonstrates the proper operation of the AMSCO 7052HP and 7053HP washer disinfectors. STERIS recommends following your facility's policies, or AMI ST79, regarding operation of your washer disinfectors. Refer to the product's operator manuals for complete use details. During this video, you will learn about the components, operation, and routine care and maintenance of your washer disinfector. Wear appropriate PPE based on your facility's guidelines. Refer to all equipment manufacturer recommendations on cleaning before processing surgical instrumentation. Before operating your AMSCO 7052HP or 7053HP washer, become familiar with the major components and controls. These washers feature an ergonomic design and easy-to-use control screen. The load or dirty side features a control screen, chamber door and lights, and access panels for performing maintenance. The electrical supply switch is located above the control screen. The unload or clean side has a control screen, chamber door lights, a second chamber door, and a printer for documenting each cycle. The washer is equipped with lighting showing cycle status. Green indicates washer disinfector is available. White indicates washer disinfector is in cycle. Red indicates washer disinfector needs attention. Inside the chamber are the rotary spray arm assemblies, a debris screen, and water outlet connection. The electrical supply switch is a rocker switch located above both the load and unload side touchscreens. Never power down the washer in mid-cycle mode. The emergency stop button is located under the control system on each side of the washer. It stops operation immediately when pressed. The washer features an easy-to-use touchscreen located on both sides of the unit. The control system monitors operation of cycles and all critical cycle parameters. This washer can process a wide variety of loads using pre-programmed cycles and also allows for custom cycles. Pre-programmed cycles include instrument, utensil, plastic goods, gentle cycle, orthopedic, MIS, anesthesia. Next, we'll walk through a complete reprocessing cycle. Before processing a load, you'll need to perform a few preliminary steps. First, open the load side chamber door. Make sure the chamber is empty and the debris screen is clean and in place. Inspect the spray arm assemblies to ensure there is no blockage and movement will not be obstructed during the cycle. Then close the door. On the unload side, you should ensure there is enough paper in the printer. Now you're ready to load the rack to be processed. Use an appropriate rack designed for the instruments you're going to process. You should be using washer racks designed for STERIS washer disinfectors. Make sure you have and follow any instructions provided for the specific rack you are using in the washer disinfector. Reference STERIS tech data sheets for complete rack details. Be sure all instruments and devices are placed inside the tray. Never place anything on the rack itself. When the 7052HP washer is loaded to capacity, it can hold a maximum load of 135 pounds. When the 7053HP washer is loaded to capacity, it can hold a maximum load of 160 pounds. Connect any required hoses for cannulated instruments according to the equipment manufacturer instructions and the instructions in the AMSCO 7052HP and 7053HP washer operator manual. Now you can load the rack onto the transfer cart. Lock the transfer cart into place and carefully load the rack into the chamber. Now you can initiate the cycle. Pre-programmed cycles and cycle icons make it easy to start a cycle and track its progress. The screen displays critical information, including cycle status, cycle performance, chemical injection, cycle graph, and other critical parameters. To initiate a cycle, select Cycle from Ready Mode to see pre-programmed options. Select the appropriate cycle for the load type and rack in use, and the washer will start the first phase of that cycle. Typically, there are multiple cycle phases. The Cycle in Process screen shows estimated remaining time. You can also monitor the current cycle parameters by pressing the Details button. Once the cycle is finished, a signal sounds and the chamber door opens. The control screen displays the cycle completed screen. A detailed printout is generated documenting the cycle parameters. Lock the transfer cart into place and carefully unload the rack from the chamber onto the cart. Technicians should use the blue cool touch handles to safely handle racks during the unload process. The washer is equipped with a messaging system to communicate to the technician that certain conditions may exist. If a reminder or other message occurs, refer to the messages and reminder charts in Section 7 of the Operator Manual to address the notification. When a problem occurs with the washer, an audible alarm sounds. The screen turns red and shows an alarm message. If an alarm occurs, press the ACT button to acknowledge the alarm and silence the buzzer. Refer to the alarm messages chart in Section 7 of the Washer Operator Manual for steps to fix the issue. If the alarm requires you to abort the cycle, press Abort. The water is automatically drained and the control screen returns to ready mode. The cycle printout records the warning and alarm information and whether the cycle was resumed or aborted. If you need to abort a cycle without receiving an alarm, simply press Stop, then Abort. Setting cycle parameters or custom cycles. This washer comes with a set of pre-programmed cycles. Each phase within a cycle has its own parameters, which can be modified to better accommodate your department's processing needs. Customized cycles can also be created. Only a supervisor can modify a pre-programmed cycle or add a new one. Start by logging in to the supervisor screen, selecting a login name, and entering a password. From here, you can modify a pre-programmed cycle or create a custom cycle. Refer to Section 5 in your AMSCO 7052HP and 7053HP Washer Operator Manual for details on what attributes can be modified and ranges allowed. To modify a cycle, press Cycles. Then, Modify Cycle, using the arrow buttons to navigate to the cycle you want to modify. You can lock or unlock a cycle, change a barcode number, or modify a phase. Once you've made your changes, press the Close button until you return to the desired screen. You can create a custom cycle by modifying the parameters of a phase, or by adding or removing a phase from the cycle. To create a custom cycle, press Cycles, then Modify Cycles. Scroll until you find the cycle you want to modify. Then select that cycle. Next, press Parameters. Then select which phase you'd like to modify. Follow the instructions to modify the parameters. Not all cycle parameters can be modified. Refer to the cycle description charts in Section 5 of the Washer Operator Manual. Once you have made changes, press Close. Any changes you've made will automatically be saved. Continue to press Close until you've reached the desired screen. To add a phase, click on Modify Cycles and scroll to the cycle you want to modify. Click Parameters. Then select the type of phase needed, such as pre-wash or wash, and click on a blank button. Then click Edit and enter the amount of time for the phase you want to add. Then click OK. Then click the Save button to save the added phase. When you've finished, press Close. To remove a phase, click on Modify Cycles and scroll to the cycle you want to remove a phase from. Click Parameters. Then select the phase you want to remove from the cycles, such as rinse or drying. Then edit the time and enter 0. then click Save to remove the phase. When you've finished, press Close. You can also create a custom cycle by copying a cycle, changing its parameters, then naming your new cycle. From the main cycle screen, choose Copy Cycle, then select the cycle to copy. Press the Backspace button until the cycle name has been erased. Type in the name of the new cycle in the Modify Cycle screen. The control stores all of your preferences and customized cycles. If you experience a power failure or need to unplug the washer, you won't have to reprogram cycles. Let's review the maintenance activities needed on a daily, weekly, or as-needed basis. To keep the washer in excellent condition, it's important to clean and maintain it regularly. Let the washer cool down before performing any maintenance. Wear appropriate PPE when cleaning or performing preventive maintenance. A maintenance schedule can be found in Section 6 of the Operator Manual. Some maintenance activities should be performed by a qualified service technician. Professional standard organizations recognize the importance of monitoring your mechanical and chemical cleaning process. STERIS recommends using the Verify All Clean Test Washer indicator on a daily basis. After the last cycle has been completed each day, you'll need to rinse off the debris screen. Remove the debris screen and rinse it under running water. Replace the debris screen. Once a week, you'll need to clean the outside of the washer, inspect and clean rack spray arms and tips, wipe off the water outlet connection, run the decontamination cycle. Inspect rack spray arms weekly for free movement and clogged holes. To clean a clogged arm, remove the locking pin securing each spray arm on the rotary spray arm hub. Then remove spray arms. For the AMSCO 7052HP washer, remove spray tip by removing the locking pin. For the AMSCO 7053HP washer, rotate each end spray tip counterclockwise and pull to remove. Clean spray arms and run in clear water to clear out sediments. Reinstall spray tips and spray arms on rack. Secure spray tips and spray arms. To wipe off the water outlet connection, remove and disassemble it, and wipe surfaces with a wet cloth. Once complete, reassemble and reinstall. Before replacing the outlet connection, wipe down the stainless steel port inside the chamber. Close the chamber door. You'll also need to clean the outside of the washer disinfector weekly. Apply a general purpose cleaner on a damp cloth. Wipe off the surfaces in the same direction as the surface grain. Run the decontamination cycle weekly to help reduce scale buildup in the chamber and disinfect the chamber and prevent biofilm from building up inside the chamber, pipes, and filtration system. Place an empty multi-level rack in the chamber. And choose the decontamination cycle on the control screen. The cycle starts automatically. Open the door and pour the descaling solution into the chamber sump when prompted on screen. Close the chamber door. When the cycle is complete, a signal sounds and the unload side chamber door opens. Rinse off the debris screen, replace it, then close the chamber door. Some maintenance activities occur on an as-needed basis. This includes replenishing the processing chemicals and replacing the printer paper and ink cartridge. Wear appropriate PPE when replenishing cleaning chemistries. The low-level sensor will trigger an alarm indicating when levels are too low. Open the new container, placing it near the container you are going to replace. The tubes are color-coded to correspond with their appropriate Prolistica ultra-concentrate containers. Check to make sure you are selecting the correct chemical. Once you have verified the correct chemical, insert pickup tube and sensor into the new container. Finally, replace the old container with the new one. For safety reasons, never empty any remaining liquid into the new container. When you see a colored stripe on one or both edges of the paper, it's time to install a new roll. First, open the printer door. Tear the paper between the take-up spool and printer. Remove the paper from the take-up spindle. Open the inner printer door and gently remove the other half of the paper roll. Insert the new roll, making sure it feeds downward from the back side of the paper roll. Press the paper feed button to advance the paper about 18 inches. Insert the end into the take-up spool slot and rotate the spool a few times to make sure the paper is secure. Reinstall take-up spool and manually roll up any paper slack. When the lettering on the printouts becomes faded, it's time to change the ink cartridge. First, tear paper between take-up spool and printer. Open inner printer door. Press on right side of ink cartridge until the left side pops out. Remove the old ink cartridge and insert the new one, left side first. Then push right side in, snapping the cartridge in place. Rotate printer ribbon wheel 1/4 turn, then reinstall paper on take-up spool. Close printer door. For more information or to place an order, visit www.steris.com/7052HP or steris.com/7053HP or contact your STERIS account representative.